Philomena has a secret, an illegitimate son who she gave up to the nuns running the convent in which she was forced to live. They had him adopted.
I signed it because I believed I committed a terrible sin and had to be punished.
The film is based on the life of Philomena Lee, who has seen her heart-wrenching story brought vividly back to life by Judi Dench.
I think she's remarkable, a remarkable person. And you don't often get to play somebody who is, you know, very much alive and with us.
Some of the scenes she did in it, especially the last one where I was, you know, they wouldn't, he went off and he was looking out the back of the car when he was going off, taken away. And I was just screaming, you know, screaming his name.
You'll be 50 today. Martin.
Her son is now 50 and Philomena wants to find him. Enter Martin Sixsmith. Once the BBC's man in Moscow, now unemployed with time on his hands and looking for a story to occupy his mind.
I had a book deal, I had a two-book deal, and the first one I knew what the book was going to be, and the second one, it, you know, kind of fell into my lap, and, you know, in that sense the film is accurate.
This is an odd couple movie, with a God-fearing, warm-hearted grandmother paired against a cynical journalist played by Steve Coogan, who also co-wrote and produced the film.
My God feels the need to suddenly wipe out hundreds of thousands of innocent people escapes me. You should ask him about that while you're in there.
It was a way to explore lots of issues to do with religion and class and faith and education and intellect through two very disparate characters.
Philomena has been directed by Stephen Frears, the man who made the film The Queen, starring Helen Mirren, in 2006. Now, that was both a commercial and critical success, winning a BAFTA for Best Film and an Oscar for Best Actress. Could it be that the British director will repeat the feat with this movie?
You should be nice to the people on the way up, because you might meet them again on the way down.
Will Gompertz, BBC News.